15 minutes past midnight, Evers got out of his car beside his home in a Negro residential area. In a vacant lot about 40 yards away, a sniper fired a single shot from a high-powered rifle at Evers' silhouette. The bullet hit him in the back, crashed through his body, through a window into the house. He died within an hour at a Jackson hospital. City detectives believe the fatal shot was fired from this sweet gum tree. They have found a rifle in the bushes, which they think is the murder weapon. They say they also have other clues. Mayor Alan Thompson cut short a Florida vacation and rushed back to City Hall, where he made this statement.
The city of Jackson offers $5,000 reward to anyone who gives evidence leading to the arrest and the conviction of the guilty.
In the Negro community, the mood is sullen anger and a desire for revenge.
Now, for many of us who've gone overseas, fought for this country, fought for Mississippi, we fought for Alabama, we fought for North Carolina, we fought for Illinois, and we fought for every state in this union. Now, we're going to stay here and see that the things that the mayor has said become a reality.
This event, this tragic occurrence, should cause all persons of goodwill to be aroused and should cause them to be more determined than ever before to break down all of the barriers of racial segregation and discrimination.
Now, although half a century has passed since Medgar Evers was taken from us, far too suddenly and far too soon, today's ceremony presents an important opportunity to recommit ourselves and to recommit our great nation to the principles that he lived and died to defend. It provides a chance to ensure that his contributions and his remarkable leadership are remembered for generations to come.
The meaning of Medgar Evers' life and death is that he embraced the fundamental struggle that the great Southern writer Eudora Welty said grew out of our sense of place, which shapes us all psychologically. The struggle between those who believe their lives only count if they control the lives of others around them, and those who feel better when they share the life around them with others. Between those who think they really only count when they can dominate, and those who've got sense enough to know that things only really work when they cooperate. It is easy to be for yesterday's change. It is easy to sanctify somebody's bones. And soon enough, we'll all be where people can sanctify ours. But the meaning of Medgar Evers' life was that he came home, and even though he had a gorgeous wife and beautiful kids and an unbelievable life to look forward to, he said, it can't be that I was a soldier in the American Army and I stood up for freedom and I can't vote.